Today, I'll show you how to make sure your skin tones are perfect in Final Cut Pro. Hey guys, I'm Rafael and welcome to the channel where our goal is to always fix it in camera and then finesse it in post, ultimately helping you achieve better creative and financial results faster. And I always appreciate the early thumbs up on the video because skin tones are awesome. But sometimes they are not, and they need to be tweaked to make them look right. Let's say the white balance was off a little bit, or the exposure of the footage wasn't perfect, or there are color casts from the environment. Or even if your monitor isn't perfectly calibrated, you may not notice the skin tones are off. The process I will show you today will let you know and correct any of those issues. But this process also assumes that the footage is already base corrected. If you shot in log, you'll first have to correct it to a color profile like Rec. 709. I made a video on how to color correct C-Log footage in Final Cut. You can find it over here. I'll show two ways to do this. One using the Color Finale plugin because I use it a lot, and one with the built-in tools in Final Cut. But the concepts can be translated to work in Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve. Though if you want a tutorial in Premiere or DaVinci, let me know if there's enough likes or comments, I'll make one. The process is simple, and with a little bit of knowledge on how to use the built-in tools in the application, you'll learn to trust the numbers and you'll have perfect skin tones every single time. Let's jump into the computer and I'll show you how. As soon as you have the project open and ready for color work, I like to hide the browser and give more space. Open the scopes. I like to have a double view. Vectorscope on top with the scale set to 133%. And make sure that the skin tone indicator is set to on. For the bottom, I set Lumascope with the IRE set to 70. Using the vector and Lumascopes, your monitor could be black and white, or you could be colorblind and you could still nail your skin tones. Learn to trust the numbers and the scopes. First, I'll use the Color Finale plugin because this is log footage. Set it to assume log. You can also double click the top of the inspector to expand it all the way down to give you more working space. Next, set the crop to just the skin. I usually choose the cheek or the forehead. Next, open up the edit layers in Color Finale and add color wheels. Here, I'll bring the gain master exposure up to brighten up the skin tone to 70 IRE. There's a bit of yellow in the skin, so I'll pull it towards magenta. Turn off the crop and take a look at the whole image to assess where it is. Check the before and after. And do any final adjustments here, like bringing down the shadows to where you want them. Now let's do the same thing with just the Final Cut built-in color tools. Add the color wheels. Because this is log, I'll add some contrast and saturation. I have a whole tutorial on how to color correct C-Log footage. There's a link in the description. Crop to the skin and make sure it's lined up with the skin tone indicator. Turn off the crop and add curves to add a little bit more contrast. This feels pretty good. Let's do another shot. This one provided by Haziel. It's C-Log from the EOS R. So let's add Color Finale. Go to Color Management, add Switch to Assume Log. Again, crop it to just select the skin. For this one, let's bring down the highlights, because the skin tones feel a bit bright. Add the color wheels, drop it down below 70 IRE. All right, this feels good. Let's check the other side of the face. It's around 50 IRE, so that's pretty good. Remove the crop and let's take a look at that. Color Finale has some great image analysis tools. False color looks pretty good. A little dark, but looks pretty good. There seems to be a bit of yellow in the skin. in the highlights. And there definitely seems to be a bit of a color cast that seems to be coming from the background. This is looking pretty good. Fairly balanced. This is one way to know that the skin tone is correct. Once again, after you've done the base color correct for log, you now can check the other colors. Turn on the crop, the exposure looks good. The color is off, check the cheek, check the other cheek and the forehead. Play until you feel it's on the markers and in the space that you like. Let's do another clip, this one provided by Jasim, who shot it on a Nikon, but we'll forgive him for that. Let's add color finale. For this one, we'll keep it on a zoom video because this is not a log profile. Let's see what we see. Crop to the skin. Check the scope. It's more on the red side, leaning towards magenta. So let's add the color wheels, pull it back towards yellow and away from red. The skin is below 70 IRE. Let's take a look without the crop. Before and after. We are definitely affecting the background a little bit, but that seems okay. You can definitely see a shift happening, but this could be as simple as the white balance being off just by a little bit. Now let's do this with the Final Cut built-in tools. Add the color wheels, turn on the crop on the skin only. Make sure the skin is near or on the skin tone indicator. Drop the luma below 70 IRE. And remember that skin should be between 40 and 70 IRE. But this is for these kind of shots. If you have a different mood that you're going for, that is where color grading comes into play. All right, one more shot. This is from Tiago at Classical Technology. And with this, we'll only use the Final Cut built-in tools. So let's add the color wheels, crop into just the skin. This is from the Canon R5 RAW. Tweak it to line up closely to the skin tone indicator and bring it down below 70 IRE. This is before and after. This is before and after. After this point, it is up to you to adjust the look to what you want. If you want it to be moodier or happier, that is up to you. The more you're pushing the color grade, this is a great way to check in to make sure you're not doing anything crazy with the skin colors and tone.
And now that you have perfect skin tones, check out this video on my full Color Finale 2 Real World Review. And here's a playlist of great tips to make better content faster. As always, thanks for watching. Give me a big thumbs up. Subscribe. I'm Raphael. I'll talk to you soon. Bye for now.